Today is 29 June, and 29 June is also known as World Scleroderma Awareness Day. This day has been specifically created to raise the awareness about this condition and also to address the different complexities associated with this condition, and also to ensure the different treatment modalities available with it. So first of all, on this occasion, I will like to send my all warm and bright wishes to everyone to know the disease in details and also to live a life better. Let's take ride in a scleroderma world.
So sclero means hardening and derma means skin. So scleroderma is simply hardening of skin. But the scleroderma is not only a skin disease, it is much deeper beyond skin, that we will see it after. So mostly women are affected of age group 30 to 50 years, and yes, it is autoimmune in nature.
Now let's see why the skin hardening occurs in a systemic sclerosis. Collagen, which is normally present in skin, when gets excessively deposited, it causes hardening of skin. It also causes alteration in the vasculature and immune irregularity, leading to the systemic sclerosis. Now, depending upon the location of the skin hardening, systemic sclerosis can be limited one or diffuse one. In limited one, it is limited to the particular area. In diffuse one, the skin hardening is generalized. Now, why this is important to know? Understand the prognosis and the complications associated with this.
Let's see what are the clinical signs of scleroderma. So common symptoms are sore and swollen fingers, Raynaud phenomenon, that is bluish discoloration of fingertips when exposed to cold, and symptoms related with the acid reflux, that is belching and heartburn. Moreover, scleroderma may present in many different ways depending upon the organ involvement. Just as in case of a lung involvement, you may have a complaints of breathlessness on exertion or a dry cough. At that time, you may need to go for the further investigation like chest x-ray, HRCT, pulmonary function test, or even for the 2D echo. If heart involvement is there, then you may have some symptoms like chest pain or palpitation. If gastrointestinal involvement is there, then you may have a complaints of difficulty in swallowing or abdominal discomfort. Generally, the kidney involvement is clinically silent, but if you experience sudden rise in a blood pressure associated with the headache or dizziness or chest pain or shortness of breath, then maybe you are in a scleroderma renal crisis. So we always advise every scleroderma patient to monitor BP at home on a daily basis. Now let's see how to diagnose this complex disease. So with the help of a clinical history, then various clinical signs that we saw before, blood test and imaging scans, and even with the help of a nail file capillaroscopy, we can diagnose this medical entity and start treatment for the same. After starting treatment, it is also important to monitor the disease for any internal organ involvement. For that reason, your treating consultant may ask you to undergo certain tests on a regular time interval. Regarding management, there is no cure to disease, but symptoms we can control and complications can be prevented. As we explained before, scleroderma can involve many systems in body, so organ-based treatment is individualized in form of immunotherapy or vasodilators or antacids and even in a form of surgical intervention that helps to improve the quality of life.
In this educational video, we explored the different corners of the systemic sclerosis, starting from why it occurs, what are its types, then what are its clinical symptoms, what are clinical signs, how to diagnose it, and even a medical and surgical treatment available for the disease to make life better.